Good morning, Paul. I am not sure how today we are discussing about class 11 of physics, chapter number 6. In this lesson, we are discussing about the concept of potential energy. So, first of all, what is the potential energy? Here, we know that the potential energy is not defined, okay? But potential energy is defined as change in the potential energy, okay? What is defined as? It is defined as change in the potential energy. So, see here, first of all, we have discussing about the potential energy. So, whenever we are talking about the potential energy, it is known as the work done by conservative force. Okay? It is known as the work done by conservative force. Now, what is the conservative force? It is electricity and also elasticity. Okay, so for that gravity, elasticity, electricity, for all this phenomena, it is a conservative force that, okay, it is a conservative force that. So that's why we are taking that the delta U or delta V, see, delta V is equals to minus work done by the conservative force. So why for the negative sign is that? Because of we have taken that the against which kind of force apply. Conservative force against that we are doing that the work. So that's why we are taking that the minus sign is there. Now, see here, whenever we are talking about only, so first of all, what is that? W is equals to WV, delta V is equals to minus 1 done by the conservative force. So it is due to the gravity and elasticity of the electrostatic. So now here, what we are discussing about that? So first of all, we need to understand this topic. We have mean that the, suppose we know about it, whenever the two, we know what is that the force that the weight or it is the weight is equals to minus mgh, but no, it is a not, it is a, but what the actual meaning is that it is a change in potential energy. So it means what is the change here? So see here, mass is constant, g is constant, so height will be changed. So due to the height will be changed, on that time what will happen? The potential energy will be changed. So potential energy will be changed. How? Because we have just considered as one thing is that, one what is that? It is put on that, on the surface, it is a ground. It will walk on the time, due to the ground, we are putting at some particular height, it is a natural. On the time, it has a potential energy is that mgh1. What is that? mgh1. And again, what we have done, we are taking that the suppose it is you are doing that the work, something works against the whole conservative force. On that time, what will happen? We are going to the reach at this height. It is our h2 height is there. Okay, it is h2. So due to the h2, what is the potential energy of that? So it is equals to mgh2. So here we have been that the work something against the force, conservative force. What we have been? We have been that the something work against the conservative force. So whenever we have been that the conservative force on that time, what we will get? We will get change in the potential energy. So see here, delta V is equals to Vf minus Vi. So Vf is our final position and Vi is our initial position. So it is equals to work. Why? Because we are applying something force on that object and it is going to the displacement. So W is equals to force into displacement. But we know that there is something against the force, that's why we are taking the minus F. Okay, so the work done is equals to minus F into B. But see here, we are applying the concept of WG. We are doing that the force against the gravitational force. So what happened? We are taking that WG is equals to that the change of position, change of height. So we are taking that the two different things, that mgh2 minus mgh1. So we are taking that the mg on outside. So we get that the WG is equals to minus mgh2 minus h1. What we will get? We get that the mg is equals to WG is equals to mg minus mgh2 minus h1. But what we know? We know that the g is our conservative force. So that's why we are taking that the WC. What we get? We will write down that WC. So WC is equals to our minus mg equals to minus h1 value is there. Okay, our minus mg h2 minus h1 value is there. So we can say we will get the value of delta V, change in the potential energy, change in the potential energy, it is equals to conservative work and other conservative force. So see here, delta V is equals to minus delta, see V minus V is equal to V delta, take it minus delta, minus delta, delta V minus V is equals to delta V, so it is equals to minus W C. So see here, this is a large value, but we are considering, the small element, so we will get delta to here V. So we are getting that V is equals to minus dWc. What we are there? Minus dWc. But here, see, whenever we are talking about the Wc, it is our work. So for work, it is equals to, we know that the F into V. Okay, but we are talking about the small element of that. So it is equals to minus I to minus V I to V here. Sorry, VI to V is equals to integration of dV, it gives you the whole change of the change in the potential energy. So it is equals to minus VI to V of dV by dV is equals to minus F due to the WC is equals to F of FC dS. So it is equals to F. We can put the value of FC into dS. So we will get that the dV is equals to minus integration of FC to dS. Now here, what is the FC? FC is our conservative force, okay? It is our conservative force is there. So see, this is our, so change in the potential energy, what will be there? Potential energy is not defined, but potential energy is defined as change in potential energy. So what is the difference? Whenever the change of the potential energy, it will on that time it will be used to the energy. So whenever when it is, but it is possible only for whenever you are talking about the conservative force. This is not possible for the non-conservative force. So see here, on that time whenever you are talking about the non-conservative force, on that time change is that. Okay, so see here, for the conservative force, what will happen? We will get that the value of my dV is equals to dV is equals to minus d minus dwc minus dwc, but dW is equals to our work, and work is equals to F into D, force into displacement. So force into displacement, we will get that dV is equals to minus FC into dS. So see, okay, so now our potential energy, it's a our potential energy is that, so this work done by the conservative force such as a gravity depending on initial and final positions only. So we already when the previous chapter about, for example, dealing with the inclined plates, if an object mass is released or placed from the top of smooth inclined plate of height as its speed at bottom is under root 2 g l irrespective, okay, so of the angle of the inclinations. So the bottom of inclined plane is acquired the kinetic energy is m g h. So now the change of the potential energy, change in the potential energy is equals to minus f of x into delta x. Now see here, the dimension of the potential energy are potential energy. We know the potential energy is that m dimension is that dimension is what m1 l2 t minus 2. It is our dimensional formula of the potential energy. It is our dimensional formula of the energy, okay. So it is our dimensional formula here. So it is equals to m1 l2 t minus 2, and its unit is joule. Its unit is joule. Its unit is joule, and its dimensional formula is delta V is equals to m1 l2 t minus 2 is that, okay. Now and this our joule and the same as the kinetic energy also. So our work joule, it is also for the work. So now the change in potential energy for